Hi dear students, in this presentation we are going to discuss about eutrophication. Eutrophication refers to the overnutrition of the nitrogen, phosphorus and carbon in the water bodies. So it is simply the over content of the nitrogen, phosphorus and carbon in the water bodies, and it is mainly because of the human invasions only. നമ്മൾ ഫെർട്ടിലൈസേഴ്സ് ഒക്കെ ആയിട്ട് നൈട്രജൻ യൂസ് ചെയ്യുമ്പോൾ നൈട്രജൻ ബേസ്ഡ് കോമ്പൗണ്ട്സ് ആണ് കൂടുതൽ യൂസ് ചെയ്യുന്നപ്പോൾ അത് വാട്ടർ ബോഡീസ് അത് റെയിനൊക്കെ വരുമ്പോൾ അതിൻ്റെ കൂടെ നേരെ എടുത്തും വാട്ടർ ബോഡീസ്. സോ വൺസ് ദ ന്യൂട്രീഷ്യസ് തിങ്സ് ലൈക്ക് നൈട്രജൻ, ഫോസ്ഫറസ് ആൻഡ് കാർബൺ എൻറ്റേഴ്സ് ഇൻ ടു ദ വാട്ടർ ബോഡി, ദാറ്റ് വിൽ ബി കോസിങ് ഫോർ ദ ഗ്രോത്ത് ഓഫ് ദി ആൽഗേസ് ആൻഡ് ഓൾ. സോ ദി കളർ ഓഫ് ദ വാട്ടർ ബോഡി ഈസ് ഗ്രാജുവലി ചേഞ്ചിങ് ഫ്രം ഗ്രീൻ കളർ ടു സോറി ദാറ്റ് ബ്ലൂ കളർ ടു ദി തിക്ക് ഗ്രീൻ കളർ. So that indirectly is causing for the or it is indirectly preventing the oxygen to react with the water bodies, or the oxygen is permanently blocked to the aquatic life. That is what is finally happening in aquatic ecosystem. Eutrophication is caused by excessive input of the nutrients. The nutrients enhance algal growth, and this in turn may have a cascade of effects on the ecosystem. See, if the nutrient availability is much higher, then that will promote the growth of the algae within the water bodies. This in turn may have a cascade effect on the ecosystem. These effects may include algae bloom. See, a large quantity the water body completely covered by thick layer of algae are simply known as algal blooms. That is actually preventing the interaction of the air with the water body. So oxygen content with dissolved within the water will be getting reduced. That means it is threat to the aquatic life. That is the end effect of eutrophication. So algal blooms, growth of undesirable algal species, oxygen depletion or anoxia in bottom water. See, the oxygen availability of the oxygen in the bottom water will becomes less. That is what is the end effect of this one. And loss of cold water fish species, unpleasant taste and odors. These are all the things, effects of the eutrophication. So the water becomes water loses its properties, and it becomes unpleasant taste and odors, and even the chemical content also with the water is also going to be increased. The phosphorus and once it is added, its chemical properties also getting changed. There are two types of eutrophication. One is natural eutrophication, and the other one is the cultural eutrophication. Natural eutrophication, that is caused by the normal process of the nature, not to interfered by human activities, termed as natural eutrophication. So it is happening everywhere in the water bodies. Large water bodies like lakes and rivers are, the eutrophication is happening permanently. Everywhere it is happening, but if it is by the natural course, then it is called natural eutrophication. And of course, the rate of eutrophication in case of natural eutrophication will be much lesser compared to the cultural eutrophication. So gradually any water body will have the same effect, because the algae is also a particular type of plants. We can span like microscopic structure, like something we can say. So once they get the nutrients, they will start growing. So if the nutrient availability is not as much as, or if it is within a particular limit only, then the algae growth also will be less only. But once the nutrient availability is much higher, then only the growth will be becoming larger, and then only it is going to be a threat to the aquatic life. Okay, so by years and years, sometimes some lakes and all has this phenomenon is happening. That is what is natural eutrophication. This sort of eutrophication takes many years to affect the water bodies in a full force. See, that years required will be much large in case of natural eutrophication. For this eutrophication to take place, water bodies not near the industrial or human habitat places are affected by such sort of eutrophication. See, water bodies, lakes, within the forest, there is no human invasion at all. There also this thing is happening, but of course the rate of eutrophication will be much less in that cases. Okay, cultural eutrophication, it is a sort of eutrophication that is caused by the human activities, mainly because of the agricultural activities and all. It is a rapid process and takes only decades to eutrophy and ultimately pollutes the water. It will take only a very short interval of time. So it is much more alarming than the natural eutrophication. It is a process that speeds up the natural eutrophication process. Now coming to the sources of the various eutrophication, is first one is point sources. Just like pollution, here also water pollution, here also point sources are the sources which is originating from a particular point, or we can identify the from where it is originating. That is what is known as point sources. See, if a water, if the water expelled from a particular industry or waste from an industry is directly expelled into the water body, then we know that that waste is coming from that particular industry only. We can identify from where that waste is coming. That type of source are known as point sources. So in that case, if needed, we can take the corrective action also. But if the source is from different points, we cannot exactly predict from where this is coming, then that is coming to the other category. Point sources are directly attributable to one influence. In point sources, the nutrient waste travels directly from source to water. Point sources are relatively easy to regulate. See, in this case, the nutrients are directly coming from a particular source to the water bodies. So it is easy to identify such source, and we can even record if we require, then we can regulate also. Industrial sources. The point sourcing, the main in point sources, industrial source. Waste from the industries are as emitted through the pipes and proper drainage points. It is the prominent point source. Now another point source is the power plant. Power plants have specific emitting points through which the waste are emitted. And the another example is sewage treatment plants. Treatment processes relaxes oxides of nitrogen and phosphorus in effluents which drain into the water bodies. So you see, all these point sources are ultimately causing the increase of the nutrients within the water bodies. Like finally, all these are reaching to the water bodies like lake and rivers. So they are becoming a cause for the contribution of the nutrients within the water bodies. So indirectly, it is helping for the growth of the algae, and finally it is becoming a cause for the eutrophication. Non-point sources, coming to the other types of sources, that is non-point sources, we cannot exactly identify from where these are getting originated. Non-point source of pollution, also known as diffuse or runoff pollution, is what which comes from ill-defined diffuse sources. We cannot exactly define from where it is coming. See, if we are using fertilizers for the cultivation, so from so many agricultural fields, the fertilizer waste will be coming in a dissolved component along with the water runoff, along with the rain, it is coming to the reaching to the water. We cannot exactly predict from which field it is coming and all. So that type is non-point source. Non-point sources are difficult to regulate and usually very spatially and temporarily with season precipitation and other irregular events. The main non-point sources are urban sources. Habitants of the urban area, when emit their waste hazardously, it becomes non-point source. So lot of waste is expelled by each and everyone living in the urban areas. So we cannot predict exactly from where it is coming, but still a lot of waste are generated. So it is a non-point source. So that finally everything is reaching to the water body along with the rainwater and all. So now the next important non-point source is agriculture sources. Agriculture waste like peats, cow dung, vegetable waste are of this type. See, cow dung is having a lot of nitrogen content. So it is a major source, non-point source of source which is causing for the eutrophication. Fossil fuel sources. If emission of fossil fuel have no specific point source, it is non-point sources. See, in for the domestic purpose, everyone is using our fossil fuel as the for the combustion purposes. So of course that amount produced from by a particular person will be very less, but if you take it as a cumulative sense or altogether, it is going to be a major source of pollution. So from this source also, not of the nutrients which is helping for the eutrophication is being produced, so that can be considered as a non-point source. Forestry and land sources are also a non-point source of eutrophication. So from all these sources, whether it is non-point source or point source, the nutrients like nitrogen, phosphate and carbon are phosphorus and carbon are anyway reaching into the water bodies, which in turn is causing for the eutrophication. Now coming to the causes of the eutrophication, the major cause for the eutrophication is the fertilizer, use of fertilizers. Nitrates and phosphates are the major content of the fertilizers that we are using for the excess production. So if we use it in an excess manner, what happens is the dissolved nitrates and phosphates will be reaching to the water body along with the rainwater and all. So excess use of fertilizers for agriculture are washed by the surface runoff into the lakes and oceans. So it is the major reason for the eutrophication. Now next cause for the eutrophication is concentrated animal feeding operation. See, nowadays aquaculture is very much common, and concentrated animal feeding operation normally discharge high scores of nutrients which find its way to the water body. So whatever we are feeding in excess, that is directly reaching to the water bodies. So concentrated animal feeding operations are another reason for the eutrophication. Direct sewage discharge and industrial waste, of course, if you directly discharge the sewages and industrial waste into the water bodies, of course, along with that, lot of nutrients can reach the water bodies, which in turn will be causing for the eutrophication. Even the treated sewage discharge and industrial waste still may have higher nitrogen and phosphorus in the sea. The only option to prevent this one is to treat the sewage water and all, but still sewage water and all, treated sewage water and all will have much higher concentration of nitrogen and phosphorus. We don't have such technologies to remove these things from the in the dissolved form. നമുക്ക് വലിയ വലിയ പാർട്ടിക്കിൾസ് ഒക്കെ നമുക്ക് എന്ത് ചെയ്യാം, സെപ്പറേറ്റ് ചെയ്ത് നമുക്ക് നെറ്റ് പോലത്തെ ഒക്കെ വെച്ച് സെപ്പറേറ്റ് ചെയ്ത് മാറ്റാൻ പറ്റും. പക്ഷേ ഡിസോൾവ് ആയിട്ടുള്ളതിനെ പിന്നെയും ട്രീറ്റ് ചെയ്ത് കഴിഞ്ഞാലും ചിലത് അതുപോലെ തന്നെ നിലനിൽക്കും. സോ നൈട്രജൻ ആൻഡ് ഫോസ്ഫറസ് ആർ സച്ച് കണ്ടൻസ്, ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് വെരി ഡിഫിക്കൽട്ട് ടു ട്രീറ്റ് ഇറ്റ് ഔട്ട്. നൗ അക്വാകൾച്ചർ, സി കോൺസെൻട്രേറ്റ് ലൈക്ക് കോൺസെൻട്രേറ്റ് ആനിമൽ ഫീഡിംഗ് ഓപ്പറേഷൻ ഹിയർ അക്വാകൾച്ചർ ഈസ് ആൾസോ കോൺട്രിബ്യൂട്ടിംഗ് എ ലോട്ട് ടു ദി യൂട്രോഫിക്കേഷൻ. ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് ദ ടെക്നിക് ഓഫ് ഗ്രോയിങ് ഷെൽ ഫിഷ് ആൻഡ് അക്വാട്ടിക് പ്ലാന്റ്സ് ഇൻ വാട്ടർ containing dissolved nutrients. So for the growth of these things that we are cultivating in as aquaculture, we have to provide continuously the nutrients. If not properly managed, may cause eutrophication. That is not a major reason, but still, if not properly managed, that may also cause for the eutrophication. Now natural events are also contributing to the eutrophication, are also becoming a cause for the eutrophication. Natural events such as flood and natural flow of rivers will wash excess nutrients off the land and water. ഇപ്പോൾ റീസെൻ്റ് ആയിട്ട് കണ്ട ഫ്ലഡ് ഉണ്ടായിരുന്നപ്പോൾ നമ്മളെന്താണ് ഫോറസ്റ്റ് ഏരിയയിൽ അവിടെയൊക്കെ ഉള്ള ന്യൂട്രിയൻസ് ന്യൂട്രീഷ്യസ് ആയിട്ടുള്ളെല്ലാം വെള്ളത്തിൻ്റെ കൂടെ എന്തുവരാണ് ചില സ്ഥലങ്ങളിൽ ഫൈനലി ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് റീച്ചിങ് ടു ദ വാട്ടർ ബോഡീസ് ലേക്സ് റിവേഴ്സ് see avadekana tipoda. So it is becoming nutrient rich, that is favoring the condition for the growth of the algae. So finally that is going to be a cause for the eutrophication. Okay, so that is all about the eutrophication. So how we can stop eutrophication? Of course, if you think about the cause for the eutrophication, if we stop all the causes for the eutrophication, we can stop the eutrophication, or we cannot stop it. By natural way also it is always happening, so stopping of eutrophication is not practically possible, but of course we can control the rate of eutrophication with the controlling all these causes. So if the question is asked how we can prevent the eutrophication, we have to stop all the causes for the eutrophication, that we can explain with this slides. Okay, thank you.